गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक टू मैथमेटिक्स क्लास. हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर टेकिंग अ गुड केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ. सो चिल्ड्रन, इन टूडेज लेक्चर आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द सोल्यूशंस ऑफ ऑल द टेस्ट क्वेश्चंस विच वॉज कंडक्टेड यस्टरडे. फाइन स्टूडेंट्स, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट टूडेज लेक्चर. दिस इज क्लास 10th, सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स, चैप्टर नंबर 7, coordinate geometry, solutions of test questions. I am going to discuss with you. Fine students, so let us start discussion children. First of all, section A, in which one marker questions were there and all the questions were MCQs. So let us start the very first question. The distance of the point P 2, 3 from the x axis is dash. So children, its solution is the distance from the x-axis is equal to its ordinate. So what would be the ordinate children? As the point is P with the 2, 3 coordinates. So ordinate is 3. So what is the right option? That is option number B. Fine children. Now children, our next question is the points -5, 1, 1, P and -2 are collinear. It is given in the question that the points are collinear, means they lie on the same line. Then we have to find the value of P. Fine children. So children, as you know that if the points are collinear, then area of triangle must be 0. The same concept I have applied over here. As the given points -5, 1, 1, P and -2 are collinear, so we can say that area of triangle is equal to 0. So what is the formula of area of triangle? That is half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2 modulus closed is equal to 0. Why I have put it equal to 0? Because if points are collinear, means they all are lying on the same line, then area of triangle will be 0 because no triangle will be formed. Let us assume these very points as x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3. Fine children. Now I am going to put these values over here. It would become half modulus. At place of x1 I am writing -5 into y2 minus y3. y2 is P and y3 is -2. Fine children. This is -2. So it would become -2, that is +2 plus 1. Into y3 is -2 minus y1 is 1, that is -1 plus x3 is 4, y1 minus y2 that is 1 minus p modulus closed is equal to 0. So let us solve it. This 2, 1 upon 2 will go on right hand side, so it would become 2 upon 1. Fine. So 2 upon 1 into 0, that is equal to 0. This complete expression has become 0. Now what I have got? I have got -5p. While multiplying -5p, this is -10. Now -2, -1, we are going to add them. You will be getting -3 into 1, that is -3 plus 4 -4p is equal to 0. Now -5p -4p will give you -9p. -10 plus 4, that is -6, and -3 will give you -9. Modulus closed is equal to 0. So -9p -9 is equal to 0. It means -9p is equal to 9. So what is the value of p? P is equal to -1, which is the right option. That is option number D. Correct students? Now children, our next question is, you have to calculate the distance of the point alpha comma beta from the origin. You know what are the coordinates of origin point? That is 0 comma 0. So this is very simple. We have to just apply distance formula, that is x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square and then whole under root. So it would become alpha minus 0 whole square plus beta minus 0 whole square and then whole under root. That would give you alpha square plus beta square whole under root. So which one is the right option? That is option number C. Now question number 4. The coordinates of the centroid of the triangle you have to calculate, whose vertices are 0, 6, 8, plus 12 and 8, 0. We have to just tell the coordinates of the centroid point. Fine, children? As I told you, it's derivation also. So, what are the coordinates of the centroid of a triangle? That is x1 plus x2 plus x3 upon 3, y1 plus y2 plus y3 upon 3. So, here are the coordinates. Fine, these are the coordinates given of the vertices of a triangle. So, this is x1, this is x2, this is x3. Add all of them and divide by 3. In the same manner, y1 plus y2 plus y3 divided by 3. So, after simplifying, I have got 16 upon 3 and 6. And which one is the right option? That is option number D. Now, children, our next question is question number 5. You have to just find out the area of the triangle formed by these vertices whose coordinates are 1, minus 4, 3, minus 2 and minus 3, 16. We have to just calculate area of triangle. Solution number 5. The given coordinates are 1, minus 4, 3, minus 2 and minus 3, 16. So, what is the formula of area of triangle? That is half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2 modulus closed. This formula we have to apply over here. Fine, children. So, here you can consider the first one as x1, y1, second one as x2, y2 and third one as x3, y3. And substitute these values over here. It would become half modulus 1 into minus 2 minus 16 plus 3 into 16 plus 4 plus minus 3 into minus 4 plus 2 modulus closed. Fine, children. So, I have got half modulus begin. This is minus 2 minus 16 will give me minus 18 into 1, that is minus 18 plus 16 plus 4 will give you 20, 20 into 3, that is plus 60. Now, minus 3 into minus 2 will give you plus 6. So, after simplifying them, I have got half modulus 48 square unit. So, definitely 48 will come out as modulus used to give us the numerical value irrespective of its sign. So, the answer will be 24 square unit. Which one is the correct option? That is option number B. Fine, children? Now, children, our next question is question number 6. If P 1, 2, Q 4, 6, R 5, 7 and S A, B are the vertices of a parallelogram P, Q, R, S, then you have to find the value of A and B. These are two unknown variables to us. Here is a parallelogram. You can see P, Q, R, S. All the vertices I have written over here. Children, as we know that diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. So, what can we say? That midpoint of PR must be equal to midpoint of SQ. And what is the formula for midpoint? That is x1 plus x2 divided by 2, y1 plus y2 divided by 2. So, through this formula, I will be calculating the midpoint of PR as well as midpoint of SQ. And I will be putting them equal. So, midpoint of PR must be equal to midpoint of SQ. Let us solve them. This is 1 plus 5 divided by 2. 2 plus 7 divided by 2. In the same manner, let us calculate the midpoint of SQ. A plus 4 divided by 2. B plus 6 divided by 2. Fine, children. So, definitely abscissa must be equal to abscissa part and ordinate must be equal to ordinate. So, let us put them equal. 3 is equal to A plus 4 divided by 2. While cross multiplying, I have got A plus 4 is equal to 6. So, what is the value of A? A is equal to 2. In the same manner, ordinate will also be put equal. So, 9 by 2 must be equal to 6 plus B divided by 2. 2 and 2 are going to be cancelled. So, I have got B is equal to 3 and A is equal to 2. So, which one is the right option? That is C. Now, children, we have reached on question number 7. The points 2, 5, 4, -1 and 6, -7 are the vertices of either isosceles or equilateral or right angle triangle or none of the above. So, let us start its solution. Let A 2, 5, B 4, -1 and C 6, -7. These are the vertices given. Okay. So, let us find the distances between them so that we can reach on the conclusion whether they are going to form isosceles triangle, right angle or equilateral or none of the above. Okay. So let us calculate the distance between A and B. So the formula is x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square and then whole under root. So it would be 4 minus 2 whole square plus minus 1 minus 5 whole square and then whole under root. This is 2 square plus minus 6 square. That is 4 plus 36 whole under root means I have got root 40. In the same manner, I will be calculating the distance between B and C. So I have got 6 minus 4 whole square plus minus 7 plus 1 whole square and then whole under root. That is 2 square means 4 plus minus 6 square, that is again 36 whole under root, that is root 40. Now let us reach on the third distance, because on the basis of third distance we can conclude that which figure they all are going to form. So AC is equal to distance between A and C, that is 6 minus 2 whole square plus minus 7 minus 5 whole square and then whole under root. This is 4 square, that is 16, plus minus 12 square, that is plus 144. Correct, children? So you will be getting root 160. Can I write root 160 as 4 into 40 and then whole under root? You know 4 is a perfect square, so 2 will come out. It would become 2 root 40. Correct, children? So children, here we have observed that AB plus BC is equal to AC. Means root 40 plus root 40 is equal to 2 root 40. So what can we say? As the sum of two shorter distances is equal to the bigger distance. So can we say like this? That this is point A, this is point B and this is point C. So when AB plus BC is equal to AC, means we can say that ABC are collinear. So which one is the right option? That is option number D. Our next question is, in which quadrant abscissa and ordinate of a point are negative? So children, its answer is third quadrant. In third quadrant, x coordinate as well as y coordinate both are negative. So which one is the right option? That is option number C. Now children, ninth question is, if A by 3, 4 is the midpoint of the line segment joining the points P minus 6, 5 and R minus 2, 3, then you have to calculate the value of A. So children, here I have drawn the line segment PR whose coordinates are minus 6, 5 and minus 2, 3. And let M be the point which is basically the midpoint whose coordinates are A by 3, 4. So children, what you have to do? You have to just calculate the midpoint of PR and put it equal to these very coordinates. Fine, children? So midpoint of PR is equal to minus 6 plus minus 2 divided by 2. That is x1 plus x2 divided by 2, y1 plus y2 divided by 2. So you will be getting 5 plus 3 divided by 2. So what I have got? I have got minus 8 upon 2, comma 8 upon 2. They must be equal to A by 3, comma 4. So we have got minus 4, comma 4 is equal to A by 3, comma 4. Here 4 and 4 both are equal, ordinates are equal. So let us put both the abscissas equal so that we can come to know the value of A. So A by 3 must be equal to minus 4. So A is equal to minus 12. So which one is the right option, children? Correct. This is C option is the right option. Now children, this is last MCQ. In which ratio does a centroid divide the median of the triangle? Children, I told you that centroid divides all the three medians of a triangle in the ratio 2 ratio 1. Fine, children? So children, its answer is 2 ratio 1 means option number B is the right option. Clear, children? Now children, we have discussed all MCQs. Now I am going to switch to section B, 2 markers each. Question number 11. Find the point on x-axis which is equidistant from 2, minus 5 and minus 2, 9. So children, as it is given in the question that point lies on x-axis. On x-axis, you know that ordinate is 0, means y-coordinate must be equal to 0. So let A, x, 0 be any point on x-axis which is equidistant from 2, minus 5 and minus 2, 9. So children, just look at this diagram. Suppose this is point A whose coordinates are x, 0. It is at equidistance from point B and C. So what can we say? That AB distance must be equal to AC. So let us calculate the distance between A and B and A and C. Okay. So first of all, distance AB. What are the coordinates of A? That is x comma 0. Fine. And what are the coordinates of B? That is 2 comma minus 5. So it would be x minus 2 whole square plus 0 minus minus 5. That is 0 plus 5 whole square and then whole under root is equal to x minus minus 2, that is x plus 2 whole square plus 0 minus 9 whole square and then its whole under root. So squaring on both sides, when I am going to take square on both sides, then under root will be removed. So let us open the identity here, a minus b whole square, here a plus b whole square. So it would become x square plus 4 minus 4x plus 5 square, that is 25, is equal to x square plus 4 plus 4x plus 81. Here x square and 4 are going to be cancelled. So while bringing this plus 4x on left hand side, it would become minus 4x. One more minus 4x is also present over here. So it would become minus 8x is equal to 81 minus 25, that is 56. So what is the value of x? X is equal to minus 7. So hence the point equidistance from the given point on x axis is minus 7, 0. Correct, children? Now children, our next question is question number 12. Find the coordinates of the point which divides the line segment joining minus 1, 7 and 4, minus 3 in the ratio 2, ratio 3. Means using this given ratio, we will have to just calculate the coordinate of the point of division. Let P, X, Y be the required point, then P divides AB internally in the given ratio. Just look at this diagram, children. This is complete line segment AB whose coordinates are minus 1, 7 and 4, minus 3. Let us assume them as x1, y1 and x2, y2. Now children, I am going to apply section formula. Fine, children? Now the section formula is P, x, y is equal to m1 into x2 plus m2 into x1 upon m1 plus m2. And m1 into y2 plus m2 into y1 upon m1 plus m2. So after putting the values, I have got 2 into 4 plus 3 into minus 1 upon m plus m1 plus m2, that is 5, which is sum of the ratio. And here I have got at ordinate place 2 into minus 3 plus 3 into 7 is equal to 5. So children, after simplifying, I have got 8 minus 3 upon 5. And here minus 6 plus 21 upon 5, that is 5 upon 5, 15 upon 5 means 1 comma 3 are the coordinates of the point of division. Now children, our next question is 3 marker. Find the area of the rhombus if its vertices are 3 comma 0, 4 comma 5, minus 1 comma 4 and minus 2 comma minus 1 taken in order. So children, here is the diagram of a rhombus A, B, C, D whose coordinates are 3, 0, 4, 5, minus 1, 4 and minus 2, minus 1. So children, the formula to calculate area of rhombus is half into D1 into D2. D1 and D2 are nothing but the length, or I should say the distance between the opposite vertices, means the diagonals. Fine. So children, first of all, I am going to calculate the length of the very first diagonal. Means I am going to calculate AC and then BD. Correct, children? So let us apply distance formula. What are the coordinates of A and C? The coordinates of A are 3, 0 and C are minus 1, 4. So distance formula we are going to apply, it would be minus 1 minus 3 whole square plus 4 minus 0 whole square. And then whole under root. It would be minus 4 square plus 4 square, then whole under root. That is 16 plus 16 whole square. That is root 32. So can I write root 32 as 16 into 2 whole root? 16 is a perfect square. So 4 will come out. It would become 4 root 2 unit. Fine, children? Now let us calculate the diagonal BD. It would be whole under root minus 2 minus 4 whole square plus minus 1 minus 5 whole square. Correct, children? So it would give you minus 6 square plus minus 6 square whole under root. That is root 36 plus 36 means root 72. So root 72 can be written as 36 into 2. That is 6 root 2 units. Now children, I have just told you that area of rhombus is equal to half into D1 into D2. So this is half into 4 root 2 into 6 root 2 square unit, because area is always found in square unit. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. Root 2 into root 2 is 2, 2 2s are 4 again into 6, so you will be getting 24 square units. Now children, we have reached on section D, 4 markers each. Question number 14. Determine the ratio in which line 2x plus y minus 4 is equal to 0. Divide the line segment joining the points A 2, minus 2 and B 3, 7. So children, here is that line segment AB whose coordinates are 2, minus 2 and the coordinate of B are 3, 7. As in this question, we have to determine the ratio in which point P, which is actually the point of division, is going to divide the line segment AB. Fine. So let the ratio be K ratio 1. So children, as you know that when we know about the ratio, we can easily calculate the coordinates of the point of division by applying section formula. So the coordinate of P will be x is equal to 3k plus 2 divided by k plus 1, and the y coordinate will be 7k minus 2 divided by k plus 1. Correct children? As children, in the diagram you can see that there is a line which is going to be passed from that point of division. So what can we say? That the coordinate of the point of division must satisfy this line. Correct students? And the line is 2x plus y minus 4 is equal to 0. So the coordinate of point P, which I have just calculated using section formula, I am going to put those values over here. So after putting the values, I have got 2 into 3k plus 2 upon k plus 1 plus, at place of y, I am writing y coordinate, that is 7k minus 2 upon k plus 1 minus 4 as it is, which is a constant value, is equal to 0. So let us multiply this complete expression by 2. I have got 6k plus 4 upon k plus 1 plus 7k minus 2 upon k plus 1 minus 4 is equal to 0. Let us take k plus 1 as LCM. So I have got 6k plus 4 plus 7k minus 2. This is minus 4k minus 4 is equal to 0. K plus 1 will be cross multiplied with 0. So we will be getting 0 only. This plus 4 and minus 4 are going to be cancelled. 6k plus 7k, you will be getting 13k minus 4k, that is 9k. And here I have got minus 2 is equal to 0. So what is the value of k? K is equal to 2 by 9. So the required ratio is equal to k ratio 1, that is 2 by 9 ratio 1. It means 2 ratio 9. Correct children? Now children, our last question is, the vertices of a triangle ABC are A 4,6, B 1,5 and C 7,2. A line is drawn to intersect the side AB and AC at D and E points respectively, such that AD upon AB is equal to AE upon AC is equal to 1 by 4. Calculate the area of the triangle ADE and compare it with the area of triangle ABC. So this is the last question of today's test. Solutions. Here is the diagram of the triangle, that is ABC, whose coordinates are 4,6, 1,5 and 7,2. In the question it is said that D and E, they are two points which lie on the line AB as well as on AC. Their intersecting line AB and AC. Find at point D and E. Clear children? Basically this is a line. Line segment which is drawn to intersect AB and AC at point D and E. Such that AD upon this complete AB is equal to AE upon complete AC. What is the ratio given? That is 1 ratio 4. But children, you know that we cannot apply section formula if we know about the ratio of some part and to the ratio of whole part. Fine, we can apply section formula only when we know about this ratio, like AD ratio DB. In the same manner, AE ratio EC. So first of all, we will have to calculate these very ratios. So for that, children, I have just drawn one line segment, that is AB, whose coordinates are 4, 6, and the coordinate of BR 1, 5. So let D be that point of division, okay, which is going to divide the line segment, and its coordinate I have assumed as x, y. Children, do you remember what was there in the question? Statement says that AD upon AB is equal to AE upon AC is equal to 1 upon 4. So let us talk about first and the third term. So let AD is equal to X, here it is written, and AB is equal to 4X. So can't we calculate DB? Of course, it can easily be calculated. If I am going to subtract AD from complete AB, I can easily get DB. Okay, because I want the ratio of AD to DB. Then and only then I can apply section formula. So DB is equal to AB minus AD, that is 4X minus X means 3X. So children, what will be the required ratio? It will be AD upon DB, that is X upon 3X. X and X will be cancelled. So I will be getting ratio 1:3. Correct, children? Now using this section formula, I am going to find the coordinate of point of division, that is D. So what it would be, x comma y is equal to 1 into 1 plus 3 into 4 upon sum of the ratio, that is 4. In the same manner, 1 into 5 plus 3 into 6 upon sum of the ratio, that is 4. So after simplifying, I have got 1 plus 12 upon 4, that is 13 upon 4. Here 5 plus 18 upon 4, that is 23 upon 4. So while applying this concept, I am capable to calculate the coordinate of point D, fine, which lie on the line segment AB. Or I can say that here is point D. Look, I have calculated the coordinate of this point D. In the same manner, I have to calculate the coordinate of point E also. Fine, children? So now I have drawn line segment AC. The coordinates are 4, 6 of A and C having 7, 2. Again, definitely I will be getting the same ratio because the same relation is given as it was given for AD and AB. In the same manner, it is given for AE and AC. If complete AE is X and AC is 4X, so definitely EC must be 3X. Correct, children? Now again, while applying section formula, I am going to calculate the coordinate of now point E. So let them be as x dash y dash. So x dash is equal to 1 into 7 plus 3 into 4 upon 4. Correct? And y dash must be 1 into 2, that is x1 into y2. Correct? Plus x2, sorry, m1 into y2 plus m2 into y1. Okay, divided by m1 plus m2. So the same strategy I am applying, 1 into 2 plus 3 into 6 upon 4, that is sum of the ratio. So after simplifying, I have got x dash is equal to 19/4 and y dash is equal to 5. Correct, children? Now, one more thing is asked in the question, that we have to calculate the area of the triangle ADE and ABC. Just look at this diagram, please, once again. This ADE is also going to form a triangle. And this complete ABC is also a triangle. So I have to just calculate this area and the complete area and ultimately the ratio. Correct? So let us calculate the area of the triangle ABC. So the coordinates I have written A as 4, 6, B as 1, 5 and C as 7, 2. And the formula is half modulus x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2 modulus closed. So here I have assumed the coordinate of A as x1, y1, B as x2, y2 and C as x3, y3. I am going to put these values over here. So after putting, I have got half modulus 4 into 5 minus 2 plus 1 into 2 minus 6 plus 7 into 6 minus 5 modulus closed. This is half modulus begin. 4 into 3, that is 12, minus 4 plus 7 into 1, that is 7. So I have got half, 19 minus 4, that is 15 upon 2 square units, because area is always found in square unit. Now let us calculate the area of the smaller triangle. Fine, which is ADE. The coordinates are A, 4, 6. D, we have just calculated 13 by 4, 23 by 4. And E, that is 19 by 4 and 15. So in the same formula, I am going to put these coordinates now. So I have got half modulus 4 into 23 upon 4 minus 5 upon 1 plus 13 upon 4 into 5 minus 6 plus 19 upon 4 into 6 upon 1 minus 23 upon 4. So children, here I have to take 4 as LCM. So I will be getting 23 minus 20. Correct? In the same manner, here also I will be taking 4 as LCM. I will be getting 24 minus 23. Fine, children? So after simplifying, I have got half modulus 4 into 23 minus 20 upon 4, that is 3 upon 4, plus 13 upon 4 into 5 minus 6, that is minus 1, plus 19 by 4 into 23 minus 24 minus 23 by 4, that is 1 by 4 modulus closed. So 4 and 4 are going to be cancelled. Half modulus 3 upon 1, this is minus 13 by 4 plus 19 by 16. Let us take 16 as LCM. So I have got half modulus 48 minus 52 plus 19, okay, is equal to half modulus 48 plus 19 will give you 67 minus 52 upon 16. So here after subtracting, I have got 15 upon 16, correct? So I have got 15 upon 32 square unit as the area of the smaller triangle ADE. One more thing is asked in the question, that after calculating the area of smaller triangle to area of bigger triangle, we have to just calculate their ratio also. So area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle ABC is equal to 15 upon 32, this is smaller one, upon 15 upon 2. So definitely I have to take the reciprocal. This is P upon Q upon R upon S. So I have to take reciprocal of R upon S, it would become S upon R. So that is 15 upon 32 into 2 upon 15. 15 ones are 15. 1, 2 1s are 2 and 2 16s are 32. So I have got the required ratio as 1 ratio 16. Correct, children? So that's it for the day. Hope you all may have performed very well in the test. Fine, children? So now this is the time to get mathematics homework. You have to do the corrections of the test. Suppose if you have done something wrong, then please you are supposed to do that very question once again so that you can better understand. And you have to read the summary of the next chapter, that is chapter number 10, circles. At the back of NCERT, I have seen nothing is given in the summary part. So you have to read these very pages which I am going to tell you. You have to read the summary of chapter number 10, circles, from pages 206 to 208. And you have to read page 210 also. So that's it for the day. Please like the video and do not forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you and have a nice day.